We've spent a lot of time praising UCLA, certainly. I want to do it some more. Johnny Juzang, I feel like that's the last we saw of him in college basketball. I feel like it has to be, right? Like, I don't know why this guy would come back. What a treat he's been to watch. We watched him closely at Kentucky, because he was a local kid coming out of LA, and like we kind of knew him indirectly. Like he was put on our radar. So like when he goes to Kentucky, I remember watching him being like, yeah, that's the kid that went to Harvard Westlake, and it didn't obviously pan out super well. And I was like, man, I would like to see him be better. And then he transferred back home, and oh my God, has he been better? And what a joy that was. That is an NCAA tournament run I will never forget. And to have you keep talking about presence of mind. Jalen Suggs had the presence of mind to know how much time was left to get the shot off, to not chuck a shot from like beyond half court. To know, you know, I can get
he
a
didn't
couple more
panic.
dribbles in. Johnny Juzang had the presence of mind down two. I was certain he was jacking to three there at the end of overtime. I was certain he was going for the win, going for the dagger. He saw in his eyes that I'm going to be the hero that's going to jump on the scorer's table after I hit this. And Kispert was guarding him and knew that's probably what he was thinking. And so he's like, I'm not giving up a three. And Juzang had the presence of mind. Like, if I hit a two, we're going to overtime and I'll just keep hitting more shots and we'll win. So, I don't know. I thought that was really mature and level-headed for him to take it to the basket. He misses a shot, gets the rebound, calmly puts it up. We see so much, like we saw in the Michigan game, for God's sakes, like Michigan, UCLA, how many of those like shots down the stretch for Michigan were they tight? Cause they were like, ah, how much time their clock sped up and they were freaking out. And Juzang was as cool as could be the entire game. And especially there at the end in overtime. And I know he, you know, the charge at the end of regulation was a bummer, but you know, he was trying to make a play and it is what it is. And you can't fault a guy for like being aggressive in those situations. So I don't know. Absolute treat. Mick Cronin I could not be more excited to go watch UCLA next season. They're going to bring a lot of these guys back. They're going to be awesome. There's real momentum, real excitement around the program and ways that certainly I've never been around since I've been going to LA every so often for work and stuff. So I can't wait to see that city buzzing. I can't wait to see Pauly excited again.
I mean, just think about where we were, Titus, you know, a few years ago when we could just walk into Pauly and no one's there really. And, you know, it's kind of like this downtrodden Steve Alford era where everyone's like, look, we get it. We're not going to be Indiana, but God,
you know who,
we win
by the
games.
Way, by the way, full circle, you know who was the final nail in the coffin for Steve Alford? You might forget this. He lost at home to the Belmont Bruins, Tate. Oh. Are you aware of that?
That was after in Chicago. We saw him in Chicago, right? And then he went home and lost to Belmont.
Yeah. And then he lost to Belmont. Everyone was like, we got to fire this guy. And my dad was just like.
He's like, again, Belmont, became. Best team in the country.
He watched an Indiana guy lose to Belmont. He was like, I'm done with IU. Give me Belmont. Yeah, anyway, sorry. Go ahead.
No, I mean, I just want to say, you mentioned Johnny Juzang. This is one of those. We joke about a Kemba candidate. Not joke, but we label Kemba candidates every single year.
Not a joke at all. Honestly.
It's not a joke. I mean, there might be a new term, a Juzang candidate, because he is everything that you need in the tournament. He's also a guy that I told you today, I heard him do an interview talking about Mick Cronin. He's like, I want to be coached. That's why I came here, because I want Mick Cronin to tell me why I'm not good and I want to get better and I love to compete and I want to win every single game. And if you watch Johnny Juzang in this game, the man competes and he competes and he doesn't stop. And like you said, the fact that he took that shot, you know, goes for two, gets his own rebound, follows his shot, gets the putback layup. I mean, everything that you could ask for from that end of the floor from them. And just the fact that Suggs obviously hits the shot, wins the game. There's nothing to be said that's negative about UCLA. I think that's the best part
of
this.
No,
there was no like
hang the banner, dude. I'm bringing a banner to Pauly home opener.
Yeah,
we're going to the Pavilion Club. We're throwing back our $12 beers in the Pavilion Club.
Let's do it.
Rubbing elbows with Baron Davis and Kerry Champion, and I'm bringing a banner to Pauly that says we took Gonzaga to overtime in the Final Four and probably should have won. In parentheses,
and honestly,
and we're hanging
we
that up with the 11 national titles.
and we know the Final Four banner should go up. Honestly, like I know that UCLA's whole thing is we only hang national title banners. I think this is the time where you put up a Final Four banner and you're proud of it.
Put up a banner that says Johnny Juzang went here.
Yeah, literally.
Put that up as well.
I think Johnny Juzang is like literally Devin Booker 2.0. That is who he reminds me of. I can't get it out of my mind. I can't get it out of my head. Every time I see him, you know, on the court, I'm like, man, this guy gives me major Devin Booker vibes. And if you're an NBA GM, not that I even care about the NBA as I talk about college basketball right now, but I would say that kid is no doubt a for sure lottery pick. And, you know, like you mentioned before, I mean, we're getting into top five territory because if you want, I mean, Devin Booker went 14th and that was a mistake, or 13th, whatever it was. That was a total mistake. So I can see Juzang shooting up draft boards. I'm happy and proud of him. I think he represents, you know, a lot of good in college basketball.
His brother came to see him, by the way, like kind of the story. What a story.
And then 10 years after Kemba, as Ryan points out here on our screen, Johnny Juzang is able to do the best thing we've seen, you know, as far as cardiac Kemba. And man, I will say this, like Johnny Juzang was a name I thought I would forget in my life pretty easily. You know, like you said, when he was at Harvard Westlake, he goes to Kentucky. He kind of gets shelved at Kentucky, as Calipari likes to do to five stars. That's the Kentucky way. Come here and we don't play you. And Johnny Juzang goes back home to Los Angeles and then brings them what they've been looking for. UCLA has needed some sort of just reinvigoration, right? Like just that feeling of like, this is what UCLA basketball looks like at the highest level. And the fact that Mick Cronin is able to get that in his second year and get it with a guy like Johnny Juzang, who is such a lovable character. My mom's texted me. She loves Johnny Juzang. You know, there's nothing better than that from a brand play. And
great name, by the way, Johnny Juzang. I think that's part of it. Like the look works. The hair looks awesome.
I already see the campaign. Awesome. I see the campaign. Yeah. You rang for Juzang. You know, that's it. That's it.
Hey there. Thanks for watching Titus and Tate. For the full Friend of the Program experience, subscribe right below and come join us for all things college basketball. The action is heating up. Come join Titus and Tate.